What's up, everybody? Thank you so much for joining us today. Today, we're going to discuss the effects the coronavirus has had on Amazon sellers and the Amazon.com marketplace. In times of tragedy and disaster, we need comfort. And for all of you e-commerce sellers out there, comfort is exactly what you are able to provide. There has been over 163,000 cases of the coronavirus that have been documented in the United States. 41% of them are in New York. Cases are growing between 12 and 18% day over day. This is a tragic time and people are tense all over the world. As e-commerce sellers, we have an opportunity to provide essential products to help the entire country stay at home to prevent the spread of the virus. Us sellers get the privilege to provide a service that brings peace of mind to the consumer shopping for the essential products, allowing life to feel just a little bit normal. From cans of Infamil to bars of antibacterial soap, from childhood board games to entertain the entire family to hearing aid batteries. It can all be purchased on Amazon.com. To alleviate backed up fulfillment centers and millions of pending orders, Amazon has temporarily prioritized household staples in the following categories: baby products, health and household, beauty and personal care, grocery, industrial and scientific, and pet supplies. The movement on some of these products is mind-blowing, to say the least, and it goes to show us even further how this pandemic has impacted our nation. We have some SKUs that sell 1,000 units in a few hours, and it consistently happens day in and day out. It really opens your eyes to the seriousness of what's going on right now, and by the looks of it, it is not slowing down. First thing to keep in mind when operating a business now is the safety of your employees and of yourself. Take the necessary safety precautions, provide your employees with masks and gloves and sanitizers, get your facility professionally cleaned a few times a week. We set aside an additional 5 minutes every hour where our entire warehouse stops production and wipes down their workstations with Lysol. We also recommend taking staggered lunch breaks to refrain from having large groups of people congregating. Safety is your main priority when continuing to operate a business during this pandemic. Now, when it comes to selling on Amazon, it is important to be aware of the following tactics when selling on the marketplace in a time like this. The first thing we are going to discuss is price gouging. By Amazon's definition, from their marketplace fair pricing policy, sellers are responsible for setting their own prices on Amazon marketplaces. Amazon regularly monitors the prices of items on their marketplace, including shipping costs, and compares them with other prices available to their customers. If they see pricing practices on a marketplace offer that harms customer trust, Amazon can remove the buy box, remove the offer, suspend the ship option, or in serious or repeated cases, suspend and even terminate your selling privileges. Pricing practices that harm customer trust include, but are not limited to, the following: setting a price on a product that is significantly higher than recent prices offered on or off Amazon. Also, setting a shipping fee on a product that is excessive. Amazon considers current public carrier rates, reasonable handling charges, as well as buyer perception when determining whether a shipping price violated their fair pricing policy. You want to make sure you are reviewing KEPA thoroughly when pricing your products. You do not want to overcharge your customers. This includes inflated shipping prices on products you ship directly to the consumer. Now, there are a few instances where this may not make sense, because as prices on Amazon rise, so do prices from wholesalers and distributors. It's basic supply and demand. We have seen some of our wholesale prices go up by 30%. So this price increase would mean an increase in the Amazon selling price. But it must be reasonable and it cannot be drastic. If it stands out as an outlier where the price increase would be too high in order to make a small percentage of profit on the product, we recommend not buying that product. Here are some ways to stay on top of pricing to make sure you aren't overcharging and to ensure your account doesn't get suspended. Consistently check your fixed price alerts on the pricing dropdown in Seller Central. We have a few SKUs a day that pop up in there and we fix them immediately. You should be doing the same. Also, you should be auditing your inventory, That means looking at every single SKU you sell and comparing your pricing to Keepa in the past 90 to 180 days. This will ensure there are no surprises and you can continue to operate your business during these times. Remember, you are providing an essential service to the community and delivering to them much more than a product. You are delivering peace of mind, comfort, and protection. Do not forget why you got into this business in the first place. I know we haven't. Millions of new Prime members have joined Amazon in the past couple of weeks, and a lot of them are frustrated to see products they find at their local grocery stores for $2.99 selling on Amazon for $11.99. You will receive email complaints and negative customer feedback because of this. We recommend putting together a response template explaining these fees so the customer is not confused as to why the price is much higher than their grocery store price. Do not forget, you operate a business. Treat it like one. I say this because we see sellers all the time forget they operate a business and get overly emotional in emails to the consumer or to Amazon. Be polite, be courteous, be understanding, and include facts in your template. Other ways to maximize sales during this time are to switch some SKUs to FBM or fulfilled by merchant instead of FBA. This is great for all of the non-essential products that Amazon is no longer receiving at their facilities, and also great for products that you know will sell right away. We have noticed Amazon giving the buy box to FBM sellers over FBA sellers frequently over the past 2 weeks, and this is due to the fast shipping time FBM offers can provide. We make our decision on what products to switch from FBA to FBM usually based on quantity and velocity. We would prefer not to ship 1,200 orders from this facility ourselves, so we will send larger quantities of products FBA. Another tactic you want to be using is to frequently be checking your products to see if they can be sent to Amazon by putting in test shipment. We have had dozens of SKUs that weren't able to be sent a day or two ago, but when we recheck them the next day, we are allowed to send them. Amazon is adding additional ACEs to their prioritized list every single day. Some of the products you have been waiting to send may have been added to that list, so check it out. These are just a few tactics we have used in the past 2 weeks to double our sales and provide even more value to the end consumer. We didn't need to raise prices astronomically high to do it either, so neither do you. We simply doubled our inputs, which in turn doubled our outputs. It's a very elementary concept. Production plans that waste no inputs lie on the production frontier. By adding more employees or inputs to your company, you are able to produce more output with the same fixed warehouse space and fixed costs like heating, cooling, rent, internet, and software, with only an increase in labor costs and supplies. And the beautiful thing is that all it takes is some aggressive buying from the same number of buyers. Envision an upside-down parabola. At the vertex or top of that parabola is your max output as shown in this graph. The vertex in our case would be the max additional output produced from adding more employees until we add so many employees, production begins to decrease. Now we have never hit our max output in this allotted warehouse space, but we know we are capable of producing 13,000 orders per day and we still have room for more production stations. It's important to keep in mind the law of diminishing marginal product, which is the downslope of that parabola in this graph here. You will reach a max output per employee due to space constraints. We know that each additional product packer we bring on can produce an additional 750 orders per day. In a perfect world, this equation would work infinitely. For every one packer we hired, we can produce 750 more units. But how many human beings can you squeeze into this facility before the production actually begins to decrease due to space and movement limitations? Now, if you could figure this out for your business, that number being that top of the parabola, the max number of employees to produce your max output, you will consistently be able to operate at your highest level of productivity on a daily basis. Now, hitting your max output during a time like this is not the best idea because that means more employees in a confined space. But to illustrate, this is the exact way we have trained our minds to think. It's thought processes like this that will allow you to continue to operate your business while some e-commerce businesses will unfortunately struggle to get by. We encourage all of you to always keep the end consumer in mind when pricing your products, and remember, by showing up to work every day, you are playing a crucial role in a desperate time where people like yourself need to step up and do what is right, regardless of how you may feel about it. We hope that everyone stays safe and protected, and we will continue to keep you in our prayers. Remain grateful and stay lit. Thank you so much for joining us on our YouTube channel. Please, if you have any questions at all about selling on Amazon, leave them in the comments below or send us a DM or a PM through social media. Have a phenomenal day.